Hey, and welcome to Ahrefs Monthly Product Updates. We have many updates to introduce this month yet again, 19 in total. Let's start with Brand Radar, massive releases this month. We've launched Brand Radar 2.0, now structured like Site Explorer, with an overview and dedicated reports for different kinds of data. It's really the only tool that shows your brand's online footprint everywhere, in the AI answers on ChatGPT, Perplexity, and the likes, and the web mentions that shape your AI visibility. See it all in one place. You'll also see two brand new reports, Cited Domains and Cited Pages, showing how often each tracked brand is mentioned in AI responses that link back to those domains or pages. Next, Google AI Mode. This tracks brand visibility inside Google's chatbot experience within its search product. It began rolling out in May in the US and is now live in the UK and India too. Right now, we're tracking about 3.5 million US queries, with coverage expanding soon. Google AI Mode comes bundled with AI Overviews for $199 a month, and is included in the All Platforms add-on. So your Brand Radar add-on just got more valuable at no extra cost. On top of that, we've added proper limits and one of the most requested features, Export. Not to forget our August data update. ChatGPT and Perplexity now have 4 months of history, while Gemini and Copilot have two. And there's more. You can now track multiple brands in the Your Brand field and see their combined share of voice. Finally, you can test it all yourself. All paid users get access to a couple of demo searches in Brand Radar with no limitations. Moving on to a brand new feature. Social media management is now in beta. You can plan, schedule, and manage posts across multiple social platforms right from Ahrefs. Go to Settings, Integrations, and connect your accounts to manage content in one place and save time jumping between tools and tabs. It's free while in beta and currently supports LinkedIn, X, Instagram, and Facebook. Lots more updates coming soon. Moving on to Site Explorer. The AI Citations widget now includes Microsoft Copilot data from Brand Radar. Next, YouTube backlinks. We can now pick up links from YouTube videos thanks to crawler improvements. Super useful if you're building links to YouTube or want to monitor branded mentions there. Expect more video source backlinks in reports as coverage expands. Up next, the ads report has been rebuilt on new paid search logic. When the target isn't found in the latest SERP, we check older ones up to a month back and display data from the most recent date that includes the target. This means fewer gaps and a much clearer picture of your paid search visibility over time. And over in top pages, you'll now see the number of referring domains with history support. We also added a column setting so you can choose what to display. On to our last Site Explorer update. We've improved the AI detection score. It now separates pure AI from AI and human mix, counts mixed content lower, and reduces false positives, so you get a more accurate view of what's really AI generated. Coming soon, very short pages will be skipped entirely for even more reliable results. We've added this AI detection to Site Audit's URL Details report, with bulk detection and filtering coming next. Moving on to web analytics. You can now save your frequently used filters as presets, so you don't have to rebuild them every time. Presets are stored per user and per project, with the option to make them available across all projects. And when comparison mode is enabled, all reports will now show additional columns with changes for each metric, making it much easier to spot trends at a glance. Moving on to GSE reports. The performance charts in GSE Overview and Dashboard now include a visibility trend. Pulled from Site Explorer, it shows the history of organic traffic based on average volume, so you can quickly spot SERP shifts and see if they affect your traffic. Export if you need all the detailed values. Next, you can also filter by URL in Overview and Keywords, not just pages. Paired with presets, this makes it easy to save page segments and jump back to the data anytime. Moving on to Rank Tracker. You can now set a limit on the number of tracked keywords for each project in the settings. This helps enterprise teams control scale, but it's just as handy if you want to keep projects tidy. And we've added a search volume chart to the performance report in Overview. It shows the total search volume of all tracked keywords, giving you a quick view of overall demand. For the most accurate data, we recommend monthly volume mode. Moving on to our last update. New in API, a site audit endpoint that returns the list of issues for any project. By default, it pulls data from the latest crawl, but you can also specify dates to compare changes, like newly affected URLs, fixed ones, and more. I'll leave a link to the documentation below. And we are done for today. That was a lot of updates. Thanks for sticking with me. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our Kenny. See you in the next update and have a great day.